Hey everybody, it is Megan Elizabeth coming at you guys live with Life Above Rubies and AboveRubiesStudio.com. And tonight I wanted to talk to you a little bit about branding and feel style sheets, what they look like. And I figured it would be the best way to do it is just to show you what it looks like for the Above Rubies brands. Okay, so Above Rubies Studio is its own LLC, and LifeSite Media is its own LLC. I own both of them. They all fall under, all of my brands fall under the LifeSite Media family. So what I have done is I just kind of created all of my brands, all of my AboveRubiesStudio.com, LifeAboveRubies.com, LifeSite Media, everything. Over the last, I would say I've been working on this for the last about year. Or maybe a little bit longer. I guess it's been a little bit longer than a year, where I started really creating these style sheets to build the brand story from. And I've had brand stories before. I had a brand story for By Megan Elizabeth and Paper Layers. Again, that was all part of the LifeSite Media thing. And everything in that was a lot more bright, a lot more sparkle lights and shimmery, glittery, crafty. I had a different kind of feel behind that, a different kind of whatever. It was all authentically me and the things that I love. I'm a very eclectic person. Even when I went to do all of the television stuff, when we were doing the pilot episode for the Enjoy the Moment show, and I was meeting with producers and meeting with major investors and producers in New York City and in LA, and I was going through training and all that. A big part of the struggle for me in like 2011 and 2012 with that was, who is Megan? Like, what is her shtick? What's her brand? What does this actually look like? I got picked on for like having different hair, and I never really looked the same in any one video. I didn't like have any unified thing, and I was always like, but that is my brand. Like, I love changing my hair and doing something different. I love, you know, making it this or making it that, right? And I kind of convinced myself that that was like my brand. So it took a little while for me to even like hone in, what does this actually look like? And I had been in business already for 6 years up until that point and had never really like honed it in. So you're always going to be developing and evolving your styles, and your tastes change, but they're always kind of revolving authentically around you. And so what I've developed and done over the last year, and I've been very consistent with, and I really want it to change with Above Rubies Studio, because Above Rubies Studio started, the website first went into existence in 2006 as just a blog, nothing crafting, nothing anything, and it didn't really have anything on it at all. It was actually just a standing homepage. It wasn't a crafting blog, it was nothing, it was just a standing page. And because I wanted it for hair salon, was the thing back then. And then when I had Genevieve and I was going through postpartum depression and all these other things, I was like, I need it. Like, I was begging. I was like, I need this. I need a template up. I need a blog format up. I need to do this. I need to have this. Like, create it for me. And it was supposed to be Above Rubies Studio. And Sean, my ex-husband, was actually the one I was pestering to do it, because he knew how to do all the technical WordPress things and I had no clue. And he was colorblind, so he put up a template, which is kind of funny, but like, it was just a thrown up thing. He thought it was red. It was actually this awful green color. But it was just like, it was there and it was something to work with, right? So as you're starting, as long as you have something there and something to work with, you can hone in the details later, right? So we eventually developed like, I didn't really want it to be red ruby, but I want it like this pinkish red, this pink ruby color. Hi Tiffany, thanks so much for popping in tonight. And we started developing this whole thing, right? So over the course of time, we had the font, we had everything. And over the last, I would say 2 years, I've really said like, I don't want anything left on Above Rubies Studio that was from what I almost feel like my previous life, which was like when I was married and what we were doing. And I wanted it to be so much more. So I went through the whole process of the rebranding. And what that looks like. So I'm going to stop rambling. I feel like I'm just talking at you guys. Thanks. I see more and more joining. Hello, hello. If I'm missing anybody, just say hi. But I wanted to show you what it looked like because I really wanted to tie what life above rubies was. I did get the poppy purse. It's actually called Pink Ruby. It is. And that's why I got it, because it was called Pink Ruby. And I was like, I can't not get the Pink Ruby purse with the navy background. So yes, I did get the new Pink Ruby purse. Yes. Hey, Barbara. Hello, hello. Oh, I'm so glad you found me tonight. Good to see you here. Okay, so what these are, this is my style feel sheet. And I created the logos for Life Above Rubies and Above Ruby Studio. I wanted them to have similar but different looks and feels, that you could tell they were under the same umbrella, the same family, but that they were their own identity as well. They're still very much a part of me and who I am. They do have a slightly different client base, and there's no lie to that. They are a slightly different demographic of who would be the ideal one or the true love for Life Above Rubies, and who is the true love or one for Above Rubies Studio. Above Rubies Studio has been around solid since 2008. It's been going strong since 2008, sold over 100,000 DVDs, have had multiple product lines and releases, and, you know, hundreds of thousands of followers across many social medias. And Life Above Rubies is relatively new. It's less than 2 years old. And I'm trying to think exactly what our anniversary is, but it is less than 2 years old that we've been doing Life Above Rubies and creating this new family and this new thing that is so very important and near and dear to my heart. So I wanted to just kind of show you, these are some of the things that I created. This is what, and it's hard to see because this my printer ink is running out, but I knew I wanted an arrow to be very much a part of the brand and the feel and the things that were going on. So the Life Above Rubies logo, you can see in a couple different ways here. There's the my signature, the Enjoy the Moments with the Megan, and what the new Above Rubies logo looks like. Now, I did tie in the same R. This is the R that was in the original Above Rubies logo. So it kind of evolved and morphed. I used some new fonts and kind of created a little differently. I still use the By Megan Elizabeth, which was my scrapbooking brand name, and it's still my name, so it kind of separates and brands that in. And the reason why I'm showing you this is that I want you to get an idea of what a style feel sheet looks like for your own brand. And you can create one of these. Hey, Linda, thanks for popping on. You can create one of these inside of PicMonkey for yourself. And you start playing and putting things together and morphing and messing around with it. You can do this with blog templates. And I'm going to show you kind of all of that right here. So I even created like an AR marker. If you go to like lifeaboverubies.com, you'll even see like this arrowhead is the little icon for Life Above Rubies. If you go to aboverubiesstudio.com, you'll see the AR. And I just really wanted to kind of blend and morph in my own feelings to this whole thing. So they're two different logos for two different websites, but they have a similar drawn together unified feel and look to them, and the fonts that we use for that. So I'm going to show you that in a minute. So this is kind of like the logo design. It's always good when you're creating logos, and this is really important. If you are not having somebody do them for you, myself or Katina or whoever you choose, the graphic designer that you choose to work on your logo for you, these are the things that you need to pull out a pen and paper. Rewatch this video later if you have to, but if you have pen and paper handy, write down these things. One, make sure you know the fonts that you're using in your logo. For example, this Above Rubies by Megan Elizabeth logo, there are four fonts in here all mixed together. There are several fonts alone. There's actually three fonts alone in Rubies. These are three separate fonts that I've smushed together and worked together to create the Rubies the way I wanted it to look. Because I didn't like the U from the one font. It's a different R from another font, and I had to make them together. So make sure you know your font. Second thing, as you're doing them, have a black and white font, have a transverse white and black font, have your colored font, and make sure they're all on transparent backgrounds. And also, it's really wise to do them in 2 to 3 sizes, okay? So you can do a small, like 50 by 50 or 75 by 75, like small icon. do them in a full size, and some will even, like, and by full size, for a logo or an icon, I even recommend, like, 800 by 800 pixels, okay? And do it in a couple sizes and have them on file, like, put them in file in your computer. And I would love to show you how I do that in my computer, but that's not going to happen tonight. I might have to do a separate video at Life Above Rubies for that sometime. Okay, so it's always good to have a couple variations and even, you know, a couple, like, icon, small images that you can, you know, it represents your logo, but in a smaller, like, watermark format or icon format. Okay, so now, from there, your fonts. Make sure you're keeping track of your fonts. Now, like I said, I'm going to show you the sheets for both Life Above Rubies and Above Rubies Studio. So you're going to see more fonts and more colors than if it was just for one website. We're going to talk font tips in 1 second here. We're going to talk font tips first. When you're picking and selecting a font, sans serif fonts are the most highly converted fonts that you will find in business and marketing, okay? They are the easiest on the eyes to read. You only have about 6 to 7 seconds to capture somebody's attention for them to read what it is that you're writing. So sometimes the more curvy, pretty handwritten fonts and things that we may like and are drawn to may actually be turning our readers off. So you want to use them strategically. So I always recommend choosing at least 2, if not 3 fonts, no more than 3, for your website and your brand to use. So you'd be using these fonts as you create marketing images, as you create video overlays, as you create whatever. And it doesn't mean you're locked in and you can only ever use those 3 fonts for the rest of all time, forever and always. But even looking at your website WordPress templates, seeing what fonts are available and that you're using there, the web-friendly fonts versus the pretty, you know, different fonts. You do want a font that is different and stands out. I know I talked about this a little bit before in branding, where we were in King of Prussia. I mean, King of Prussia Mall is the biggest mall on the East Coast. It actually has more stores in it than the Mall of America, which is the biggest mall in the United States. And it's right near here. And there was a new store that went up and in that was like, their sign was one font, and it was a completely like default font that was so recognizable, like anybody that works in fonts or computers would like know it right off the top of their head. And I was like, how does that stand them apart as their own brand? Like, it just looked so cheaply like we threw something up with our name on it and there it is and done, especially for that area and that store. And it kind of surprised me, and I was like, you know, that's like a really, not that you can't use it or do it, because they did, obviously. And I'm sure there's tons of people that don't know and are not nearly as familiar with them as somebody who's in design and doing those things. But I thought, you know, Above Rubies Studio, like, piecing and working together those different font styles to create something that is your own, that uniqueness, that feeling, that stands out. It stands apart. Even if it's not perfect, it still looks different. And you can't quite put your finger on what looks different about it, but it's different, right? So I always encourage that. So thinking about your 3 fonts, you want to find one that is different, that isn't just the default, like, what, you know, 12 or 13 stock fonts come preloaded on your computer. Go out and do some research and make sure you're using commercial use licensed fonts, because if you're using a for personal use only and creating a business logo, you could find yourself in trouble. But finding those 3 fonts. So some of the fonts that I use and you will see is the Hoefler Text, the Baskerville Italics, the Geo Sans Light. So this is my sans serif font that I use most for Life Above Rubies, okay? And they're kind of mixed up because these are for Life Above Rubies and Above Rubies Studio. The ones that I use for Life Above Rubies is the Hoefler, the Nikki, and the Geo. Those are the main ones that are used, and you'll see on both the website at lifeaboverubies.com, and you'll see them also like in the logos and in video overlays and all that good stuff. And then for Above Rubies Studio, you'll see more Baskerville. You'll see just 1 or 2 letters of the Crunchy Pro. I use it from time to time as my handwritten font. Don't use it too much. The font on both websites when you go to lifeaboverubies.com, like the actual main body. Hey, Michelle. Main body is the El Greya. I don't know if I can say them all right. That's the font that you will see as the main body. It is a slightly serifed font. Okay. But it's not a full serif. I know I'm probably throwing out terms that people are going, what? You'll see Roboto as another sans serif font, and then the Didic Gothic as another sans serif font. So I have a total of three sans serifs, three serifs. Okay, so the three sans serifs is the Geo, the Didic, and the Roboto, meaning they're basically just very straight, no extra lines. Like if you look at Hufflar text, there's like the lines with the H and the E and the F and T. Okay, so these are the serif fonts, the Hufflar, the Baskerville, and the El Greya. And if I'm saying them wrong, I'm sorry. Anyway, so those are fonts. So you want to pick three, and you can pick that font, the handwritten, the sans serif, and the serif, and stick with those as your main theme. And look around. Like, there are so many thousands upon thousands of fonts out there. You will find something that you're drawn to and that you can be like, yes, I can stick with this for at least a year or whatever the case may be. And then for colors. Okay, so this side panel is all the colors that are really for Life Above Rubies. So we have like, it's like a poppy red. I wanted the ruby to start being more predominant, but I didn't want a true deep ruby red. And I'll go into a little bit more why and how with that in a minute. I really wanted to use some more neutral colors, the grays, blacks, creams, white as well. If you go to my new Instagram page, and this is brand new and I actually haven't talked about it because I've been working with Instagram strategies to grow that. And I'm so excited. It is almost at 400 followers since November. I want to say it was November 28th that I started it. And if you just go to Instagram, it's at Life Above Rubies is the new Instagram. I think that's when it started, the end of November. And I'm just using organic Instagram growing strategies that I'm excited to share with you guys, but I want to make sure that I'm trying, testing, and they're true before I say do it, because they're different for me. Anyway, Instagram has changed a lot over the last year. So almost all the red you see is this hex font, this hex number, and that's what it looks like. So I have all the hexes there, so I can just refer to this sheet whenever I'm creating anything and just type in the hex and I can be done. There are, once again, web-friendly colors and non-web-friendly colors. You can check out web-friendly colors. If you just Google web-friendly colors, you can check to see how well they will translate. And I already know there are two colors on here that look different depending on the browser you're on or device you're using. Okay, they are not the most web-friendly colors. And I'm kind of kicking myself a little bit for that, but at the same time, they're not awful. They don't clash. They don't look crazy. So we've stuck with it for now. So these are the colors that you'll see. So the like poppy red, the dark gray, a white, and then this kind of minty teal. And it's a more mint teal than it is a true teal. And then for Life Above Ruby or Above RubyStudio.com, I want it to go a little bit more bright and airy, but similar. So it's actually in, I used colorschemer.com to create a monochromatic color scheme based off of this color. So that's what I did. I created a monochromatic color scheme that the colors tie together, but they're different. They're a little bit light and airier at Above Ruby Studio because of that look and feel. So Above Ruby Studio is a little bit more coral, a little bit lighter gray, more cream, and a little bit more of a blue teal on the other side. Okay, and the color looks kind of weird here, printed because I'm running out of ink on my printer to show you. And you'll see the colors look really weird here as well. So then further creating style sheets and getting to know your one. And if you're digging deeper with the Once Upon a Time, you will be doing similar things, okay? And actually, I'm just going to go ahead and show you this. When I went about redesigning AboveRubyStudio.com, which I did sometime in the middle of last year, I redesigned it. This is what I created. I did a website mock-up. This is a template mock-up that I made strictly. And you can see, like, if this was before I finalized the font. Like, I had the same font, and I was like, no, I don't really want that. I want a serif, sans serif. I wanted to really mix it up. So this was, like, the mock-up that I did at the time. I put the little, like, you know, I want my social media icons up here, and I knew I wanted to have this three block thing, which they're actually circles now if you go over to Above Ruby Studio. But I created it. Like, I created this entire template just in Word. This is not an actual working website, but I knew what I wanted in my sidebar. Okay, so it says, like, join VIP. And this is before I created the graphics. It was like, join VIP, live event, follow the journey, why I'm here. Like, the footer, everything. So you can really do this and it be able to hand this over to a web designer or hand this over to myself and say, here's what I want to create. You know what I mean? Like, even if you don't know how to do it in WordPress or make it come to life yourself. So I've gone through several, like, I feel like identity crises. I shouldn't say they're identity crises. The identity's always been the same, but like expressing the brand or expressing the identity had been a struggle. Like I said, like, my hair always looked different, and what am I really? And I really like bright colors, yet I really like the country thing. And it was really getting quiet to, like, embrace the full story of what it is that I wanted people to feel when they came to me based off of who I really am, how I really dress on a day in and day out basis, what I'm surrounded with, what does my home actually look like if you were to walk in and be a part of that? What little things can I incorporate, like my love of coffee, that are a part of me and a part of my brand, in a sense, even though I'm not a barista here, I love my coffee mugs. Even if I'm not actually drinking caffeinated coffee, I have my warm drinks, I have my waters, like I always have within arm's reach some form of a cup or mug or whatever by me. That's like who I am and what do they look like. And yes, it's eclectic, but it's a same kind of feel. So when I went with doing, and Above Ruby Studio, kind of the whole brand and look came together before Life Above Rubies. I'll show you some of the things. I knew I wanted it to be a little bit more fresh. I knew I wanted those pinks and corals to stand out a little bit more. I really wanted those lighter grays, the computer, the crafty, everyday life kind of thing. This was like a lifestyle blog coming together from that standpoint. So I'm talking about makeup on there. I have all the crafting stuff still there, still talking about that. I'm doing more of the television and the special appearances thing over there. I'm talking about life coaching and Above Rubies, Life Above Rubies at Above Ruby Studio. So I created this little kind of style sheet of background images and textures. So you can see, like, there's this gray wood planking and the soft pink kind of fun paint splatters and the gray Swiss dots all kind of coming together. And these are the circles that ended up being over there and how they looked. Just the fresh life of plants and a little bit of sparkle and glitter. And, you know, my wardrobe really ties in with this website as well. So I wanted that to kind of translate at aboverubystudio.com. So additionally, at Above Ruby Studio, I'm thinking about, okay, who is that one? When we talk about your one true love and what they look, what they like, where they shop, where they go, create a style sheet with that. And that's very much what I did in the process of creating. So it was almost like getting really like, okay, what do they wear? What do I wear? Well, I'm a very, like I said, eclectic person. I love my hoodies, but I love my fancy tank tops. I have more different color skinny jeans than Gap, no lie. Putting that in there, LS Forte is for Life Above Rubies, but it's a sweatshirt, but it's kind of a dressy sweatshirt, and she dressed it up a little bit. This is so me, okay? But it's also kind of the type of person that I see being a part of what it is I'm doing. These are some of the clients that I work with and love. There's a part of you, I'm sure, if you have watched, you see that eclectic style and you've been drawn to little parts and pieces of it that aren't all conscious on your end. Okay, so like the Coach perfume, but it's also like, it's not about all the big fancy crazy jewelry. It's still like that handmade, she believed she could, so she did, like, hand stamped and rustic feel. Little bit of casual, but a little bit of classy and sassy, maybe with some heels and pumps, but still the ripped jeans and the t-shirt, you know? The Amazon shopper, the How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days movie watcher kind of look feel was happening, translating over to aboverubystudio.com. But when you look at Life Above Rubies, the feel sheet is a little bit different. okay? It's a little bit more the classic Starbucks red cup. And the jeans, but the sweater, the jacket, the boots, the once upon a time jacket. Still the Amazon shopper, maybe the Target shopper, but still likes those classy designer bags. They still kind of step up in there. You still see the crossover in some of the things, but it's slightly different. It's a little bit more of a shabby chic, rustic feel. Growing up in historic Pennsylvania, there is so much of that that is a part of me. It's part of what all the homes that I've lived in classically, like that I'm drawn to, that I want to live in, on top of that I do live in, are, you know, the cream colored bricks or the dark red bricks. That dark red brick really translates well with the colors that I showed you, as well as like the wood planking and some of those older, more rustic feels, but it still has that like clean, classy, shabby chic edge. So then you have some of like the textures and the designs that you see happening at Life Above Rubies with those things. So the dark classic red brick, the red barn doors, the cream colored bricks, you know, so these are some of the textures and feels that you end up finding and seeing, even though it's primarily, you know, you're based online, you're doing your laptop lifestyle, business life balance the way you want it. You know, even doing some of the photo shoots, I was like, we have to go and do this in my Pennsylvania rich places. Even when I go to Wisconsin, you know, we did that big photo shoot at that blue brick wall. It was still like the brick. It was the pop of color, but it was still like, I love the textures of the bricks and stones and wooden feel. I still really like that earthy side. I'm not really a super modern. I like white, clean feeling things. I like the more airy things. It's kind of a little bit more of the draw at Above Rubies Studio, but I also really like some of that shabby chic classic at Life Above Ruby. So I kind of blend and morph them together and create my own kind of thing. And it really kind of comes out. You know, you'll really see a lot of coffee mugs and cups translating throughout those things. Even if you're at the Life Above Ruby's Instagram, it's a lot of posts revolving around coffee thoughts and coffee mugs and posts about that kind of thing. So what these allow you to do is really give you a roadmap and an easy button to turn back to. Once again, when you feel like, I don't know what to do next, I don't know what content I'm going after next, what you're able to do is refer back to your once upon a time story and say, okay, what do they like? What did I say and set out that they like and that they want? And then ask, be involved. Okay, one thing you do learn when you're hanging out with your true love, you're asking them constantly, where do they struggle? Where do they need my help? Where are they hanging out? How can I talk to and communicate that with them better? Not just tell them what I want them to hear. How do I communicate and have a pulse on what really matters to them most? Because they are not me. They are not me. So while I'm attracting and being myself, I am bringing out their best self and they are bringing out my best self. And that's kind of how this whole dynamic ends up working really well for building your business. That's how it works across the board. And so, I mean, like when I look through a success story after success story after success story, whether they knew they were doing it or not, the same principles applied. They didn't call it once upon a time. It wasn't a fairy tale to them, but they use the same exact strategies to implement and make it work. I just want to implore your creative side a little bit better, a little bit deeper, so that you can take a look and start putting these photos to paper. You can start creating your feel sheets, your brand sheets. Start looking at those three fonts that really work for you, those three to four colors that really work for you. Really start finding those three or four textures that will kind of be a theme and run throughout. And start putting those things together, okay? Like start making sure that like, okay, how is it that I'm dressing? You know, am I classy, like I love dressy dresses and I wanna be like in the business suit attire and I want really high fashion, high designer, high-end clients? Well, then you need to have a brand that reflects that high-end, high impact client. I always felt like I like a few high end classy things. Like I love high end purses, like my Coach purse. I love designer handbags. I feel like it's one thing that makes me feel put together and stand apart a little bit. But at the end of the day, I'm not like a designer jeans, designer clothes, designer shirt wearer. I just like my designer handbags. I still shop at Target. I still, you know, these are still like who I am, but I like a little bit of fancy. You know, it's like a little bit country, a little bit rock and roll. I'm a little bit of Memphis and Nashville with a little bit of Motown in my soul. I couldn't help it. I had to go there. But it's true. Like, it really is true. Like, I love my colored skinny jeans, like, which are starting to kind of go out of style a little bit. And I hate to admit it, but they are. It's sad. I literally have more colors of skinny jeans than I probably do colors of ribbon at this point in my wardrobe. No lie. And I don't, like, it's not like I go out and spend hundreds of dollars on clothes. I really don't. But I've collected them over the years. Just like them. Just like them a lot. Anyway. So it's just really digging in of, like, who you are, what your brand reflects. You know, are you, like, the ponytail wearing t-shirt fitness girl? Are you the classy, you know, business suit attire or fancy dress wearer, and that's what you want to reflect? Like, what is it? Like, who are you? And I never want anybody to feel like you can only be successful if you fit into this mold or you fit into that mold. You don't have to fit into any mold to be successful. All you have to do is be authentically you and put the success principles into action, okay? I talk so many times about the triad of success, which is really, once again, it's the skills and the knowledge that you learn and implement. It is the community and the accountability that you build around yourself. Oh, and the desire and the vision, the desire and the vision. So you need to have a desire and a vision. Nobody else can force you to have a desire and a vision, belief system, mindset to do and to act and to see what it is that you're creating. People can only help you with the skills and the knowledge and the accountability and the community that you build around it. So those are really important for you to implement in what it is that you're doing and to step out and go, you know what? I have the accountability and the support system to know that I can do it. That's going to support my beliefs and my vision that are going to help me learn more skills and implement my knowledge. And so the triangle goes. So I don't know why my brain went off the train tracks there. I've said it 8 million times over the last 3 or 4 years. Just gone. But that happens sometimes. So, it's probably because I still have a little bit of Donny Osmond on the brain. I'm still singing country and rock and roll deep inside, and I can't, when the song, you can't stop the beat. I'll spare you. I won't sing that one too. All right, guys. So if you're here and you're going, okay, so what should I do? Start here. Start with your colors and your fonts. Start with maybe a logo or an icon or something that kind of stands out to you. Part of what I do when you work with me one-on-one is we really go through this stuff, and I will even help you. I can't do all the work for you, but I will help you with some of that graphic design help to get you started. If you already have a graphic designer, great, go work with them and do that. But if you're like, I'm a solopreneur, I'm just getting started, I don't have tens of thousands of dollars to pay for a logo and pay for a field sheet and pay for all of these things, then let's get to it together. We can do this. We can make this happen for you. You can come over and apply for a one-on-one 30-minute call. Absolutely complimentary. We can talk about these things and figure out where you can go. I would love to talk to you. And I hope you have a wonderful, amazing night. Enjoy the moments. And I will be seeing you guys again really, really soon. If you have any questions, as always, you can let me know. I just adore you all so much. I hope that you just have an amazing rest of the weekend, and we'll be talking again soon. All right, bye guys.